Welcome back to Gate Baba. In this lecture, I will be giving some of the expressions for finding the rate of heat transfer in different types of slabs. Okay. The case one. The simple slab. Okay. And I'm attaching again the coordinate system to this slab. In this direction x, that is thickness, and in this direction I am attaching temperature. Okay, the initial temperature is T1 and here this side temperature is T2. So what are the assumptions to derive the expression for rate of heat transfer? The first one is it is one dimensional heat transfer, and the second one is K is constant throughout the material. It will not depend on the material composition or it will not vary with the temperature. And the third one is T1, T2 are constants, and these two are also not changing with time, right? So it is a steady state, one dimensional, and thermal conductivity is constant, and the temperature also constant, and the thickness of slab is also constant. Here x means the thickness is also constant. By the way, the fifth thing is here the area of cross section is also constant. That means whatever the area in this side, the cross section area here also same. At any section, the cross section area is constant. A cross section area is constant. So what is the case of variable cross section area? If the slab is something like this, then that is a variable cross section area. So here the area of cross section is very high. Here it is less. Here it is very less. Okay. Here that is not our case. Here our case is constant cross section area case. Okay, with these assumptions I am forwarding my expression. We know from Fourier law of heat conduction, Q at any x is given by minus ka dt divided by dx. So from variable separable method, qx dx equals minus ka dt. We know that k is constant, a is constant. So integrate t from t1 to t2 and x from 0 to final length, that is the total length, that is thickness. I am taking a thickness as L, right? So if I do that, it is ql equals minus ka t2 minus t1. That is nothing but the heat is given by, the rate of heat is given by minus ka t2 minus t1 divided by L. Okay, it is our expression to find the rate of heat in a slab with constant cross section area. Okay, and this term can also be expressed as q equals t2 minus t1 divided by L by ka. Why I am writing like this means I want to compare this thermal analogy with electrical analogy so that the problem solution will become very easy when we go to the composite sections. So here the concept of electrical analogy comes into picture. Electrical analogy. Okay, in electric analogy we assume, that means we compare the current with the rate of heat and the potential difference with change in temperature, and the resistance of electric resistance is compared with thermal resistance. So this denominator term is called thermal resistance. Okay, so that means if I take electrical circuit, that means it is like this, and current I is flowing from V1 to V2 voltage. Okay, and this resistance is called, wherever the current is constant, okay, throughout the current is constant at any section. Here also heat is constant at any section. Here heat is Q, here heat is Q, here also heat is Q. Q will not be different at different sections. Q is constant throughout any section, right? Like here, I is also constant, and this is electrical resistance. If I compare this with the thermal section, it will be, it is Q, everywhere Q, and it is the initial temperature and it is the final temperature, other side temperature, sorry. The resistance is given by L by Ka. Okay. In current analogy, we will write I equals del V by R. Like that, here also Q equals del T by R. That means T1 minus T2 by L by Ka. Okay. This is our expression. Now come to the case 2. Case 2 is a composite slab having multi layers. Okay, for each and every layer there is a different thermal conductivity K1, and for this layer K2, and for this layer it is K3. So thermal conductivity is different for different layers, but for a given layer the thermal conductivity will not change, it is K1 only throughout the section. And for this third layer also K3, throughout the section K3 is constant. But for different types of layers, it is different, K1, K2, K3, right? And the thicknesses are, I am assuming it is like L1, L2 and L3, okay? And the temperature of this space is T1, it is T2, it is T3 and it is T4. That means heat is flowing in this direction. So, if I draw an electrical circuit with this diagram, to this diagram, it will be like, start from T1 and first resistance due to this thickness, and after second resistance due to second slab, and third resistance due to third slab, and again the final temperature is T4. So the total potential difference is T1 minus T4. The total potential difference is T1 minus T4. Okay, here the initial resistance is for first slab, it is L1 by Ka, right? And for second, it is L2 by K2A. It is K1A, it is K2A. And for third, it is L3 by K3A. Okay? And heat is Q throughout the sections, right? So, Q can be written as the potential difference, that is T1 minus T4 divided by sum of resistances, because these resistances are in series. If our resistances are in series, we just add them. If they are in parallel, we find the equivalent resistance and then we will add them, right? Here there is no need of equivalent resistance because the resistances are in series, we just add them. So L1 by K1A plus L2 by K2A plus L3 by K3A, and it is our expression. Sometimes you may not give the final temperature T4, he may give the T2 or T3 something, or he may ask to find the interface temperatures. Then you have to do one thing, just take circuit up to here. Then what is the expression for Q? Q is T1 minus T2 by L1 by K1A. Okay, or you take circuit between this point to this point, okay, and this point is T2 and this point is T3, right? And if you take circuit between those points, you will get T2 minus T3 divided by L2 by K2A. If you take the last circuit, that is T3 to T4, then the equation becomes T3 minus T4 by L3 by K3A, right? So these are the expressions. If you want to find the T2 with the known values of T1 and T3, just equate these two expressions and you will get interface temperature T2. So most of the gate questions are like this only. Find interface temperature, find the rate of heat flux, like those very easy simple questions. Okay. And third case, somewhat complicated. Case 3 for a slab. Here the slab is having, up to now you know that slab is having the constant cross section area. Here it is a constant area throughout the section. But now our case is not constant area. We are taking different layers one over other. That means layer 1 This is the layer 1 and this is the layer 2. And after a separate layer, layer 3, right? And for this the thermal conductivity is K1 and for this the thermal conductivity is K2 and for this it is K3. The thickness is same. It is L1 and it is also L1, right? Or you can take L2 also. Both are having same thickness, but I am representing with another letter. Here the thickness is L3. Heat is flowing in this direction. Here the heat will divide into two sections. Here Q1 and here Q2. Okay. Now draw the electrical energy for this case. It will be like first Q is coming. Okay, Q is coming. And after it is divided into two sections, the first section and the second section. And for the first section, there is a thickness, that means there is a resistance. Okay. And for the second section, there is also some resistance. Right. After that, they are united. So just join them. And after that, there is a section, third section. This is having some resistance. And this is our electrical circuit. Okay. Here, Q is coming. And it is divided into Q1 and Q2. And again, united like Q3. Q3 is nothing but Q again. Okay. And it is our electrical circuit. Thermal circuit. Sorry. So for the first one, resistance is how much? L1 by K1 A1. Here A1 is very important to know. A1 is this much area only. This cross section area only. Not the total area. A2 means this cross section area only. Not the total area. But here A3 means the total, this much area, total area, okay. This is the key point here to know. This is L2 by K2 A2. A2 is different than A1. And here the resistance is L3 by K3 A3, right. Here the tricky part lies. Here the resistance, the two resistance are in parallel and those two are in series with the next one. So we have to find the equivalent resistance to the circuit. That circuit will become like this. This is R equivalent and then this is L3 by K3 A3. Okay. And Q is coming, Q is leaving. Okay. Here the temperature is T1 and here the temperature is, what is the temperature? I have forgot to mention. The temperature is T1, here the temperature is T3. Wherever the temperature, interface temperature is T2 only, okay. So it is T3. So the total equation becomes rate of heat flow is given by T1 minus T3 divided by R equivalent plus L3 by K3 A3. So how to find R equivalent? R equivalent can be find out by 1 by R equals 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. Okay, from this, what is 1 by R we have to find equals what is 1 by R1? That is K1 A1 by L1 plus K2 A2 by L2. If you invert this relation, you will get R equivalent. You just put the R equivalent in this expression, then you will get the rate of heat flow. For a composite slab having different thermal conductivities and having different thicknesses, right? And this is all about the slabs cases with conduction heat transfer only. If I take convection heat transfer into consideration, then this will become changes. How? That means the inside surface is in having convection and outside surface also having convection heat transfer. Then the total expressions will become. Let me give you a simple example for a slab initially. Plain slab. Okay, having T1 temperature here, T2 temperature here. This is the temperature profile and thickness of L1. And some convection heat transfer also there. So that's why this is the convection heat transfer locations. Okay, here the ambient temperature is TA1. Here the ambient temperature is TA2. Right, so now the electrical circuit will become like this. First from TA1 starts with TA1 and Q is constant, we know. the first resistance is convective resistance and then conductive resistance within the slab, and then again outer convective resistance, and the final TA to temperature, surrounding temperature. Okay, and this conductive resistance we know very well, that is L by KA. And for convective resistance we don't know. So what is the convection heat transfer equation? That is HA delta T, and it can be written as delta T by 1 by HA. So this 1 by HA is nothing but the convective heat transfer resistance. Okay, and that is 1 by H inner area. This is inner area, so H inner A, and this is outer area, that is 1 by H outer A. Okay, is that clear? Now the rate of heat transfer is given by the potential difference is TA1 minus TA2. The interface temperatures are okay, T1 and T2. The total potential difference will become TA1 minus TA2. Okay, and the total resistance is R1 plus R2 plus R3, because these are in series. So R1 is 1 by H inner area, H inside heat transfer coefficient, plus A inner area, plus conductive resistance L by KA, plus outer resistance 1 by H outer A outer. Now the last case is most complex one, with having all these types. Last case, case 5, and it is having a slab like this, a slab with the two layers one over other, and a final slab like this, and here, and here atmosphere is there, that means convective heat transfer is also present. Heat is flowing in this direction. The temperature here is T1, and the temperature at the interface is T2, and here T3, and here T4. Okay, and the surrounding temperature is T ambient 1, and it is T ambient 2. Here inside heat transfer coefficient is HI, outside heat transfer coefficient is HO. Here this area is A1, this area is A2, and this area is A3, and this is having K1, K2, K3, K4, and area 4. Okay, so these are all the values. So if I draw an electrical circuit for this, how it looks? Something like very complex but very easy to solve these questions. First, the temperature is TA1, start with TA1, and it is having convective heat transfer here, so that's why some resistance will be there, that is convective resistance. Okay, and after that a slab is having thickness of L1. Okay, so conductive resistance. Okay, and again it is split into two components, Q2 and Q3. So it is having conductive resistance, and the third slab also having conductive resistance, and it is again coming into one way, and that is having the last conductive resistance, that is L3 by K3 A3. Okay, and the convective resistance, outer convective resistance, that's it. It is outer temperature TA2. It is the first resistance 1 by H inner A, plus it is the second conductive resistance, that is L1 by K1 A1, and it is L2 by K2 A2, and it is L3 by K3 A3, and it is L4 by K4 A4, and it is 1 by H outer A. Okay, it is the electrical circuit. Where is, I have no space here, let me increase my space. Here you have to find the equivalent resistance for this parallel connection. Okay, you can't directly put L2 by K2 A2 plus L3 by K3 A3, you have to find the equivalent resistance first, then you have to solve the problem. So for that, equivalent resistance is given by 1 by R equals 1 by L2 by K2 A2 plus 1 by L3 by K3 A3. Okay, from this you will get R value. you just put the R value here, and the total becomes series connection. So 1 by HA plus L1 by KA plus this R value plus L4 by K4A4 plus 1 by HOA, and that will give us a total heat transfer rate with having convection heat transfer and conduction heat transfer. The total equation becomes T1A minus, so TA1 minus TA2 divided by total resistance. Okay, and that is our final answer.